Hello everybody, welcome back. I'm Amanda Song.
I'm Kyuho Song.
Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. While I was watching Train to Busan, I discovered something. Ooh, it's so exciting. I can't wait to tell you. I really hope you kind of enjoy this, but alright. We recently watched Train to Busan, but unfortunately a copyright strike.
Wait, it's just like
we could not upload it and share it with you. We tried to upload it.
No!
But it got taken down immediately. So we're sorry about that, but we will be uploading our reactions on TikTok and Instagram, so please check it out there. You can see our reactions.
Link is below.
And also on our channel page. I discovered something about Train to Busan that I bet a lot of people completely overlooked.
Fire away!
Oh my god, I'm so excited. Okay. Train to Busan, I believe, is a metaphor for the Korean War. Okay, I know that's a huge assumption, but why do I say this? I think Train to Busan is a metaphor for the Korean War because, first of all, if you map the journey of the first year of the Korean War when the North Koreans invaded, and the journey of the train in Train to Busan is very kind of like similar journey. So like first, when North Koreans pushed into Seoul, like pretty much everyone had to leave Seoul and emigrate south, not like emigrate, and move south for their safety so that they wouldn't be caught up in the fighting. So first, they went just a little bit south. Like first, they might have gone to Daejeon. And first, the first train stop is Daejeon. But then, so Koreans back then mostly walked. They didn't have a lot of like cars. There was maybe some railroads set up. But most of them, as recorded in the history books, walking. So they finally arrive in Daejeon. But guess what? Just like in Train to Busan, it's already overrun. The fight has already come to Daejeon, so they can't stay there. Or if they stay there just to meet their family, they have to leave almost immediately because there's already fighting. Just like in Train to Busan, how it's overrun with zombies, the armies just keep pushing south, so they have to keep running south. So they walk south, now they want to go to Daegu. They're walking to Daegu, they battle through like hunger, the weather, like random like American or North Korean like troops. If they finally, and like airplanes flying overhead, shooting at them, they finally arrive in Daegu. But guess what? The fight is already there in Daegu as well. So Daegu is not safe anymore. And just like in Train to Busan, once they arrive at Daegu station, like the trains are all like completely fucked. There's a train full of zombies just sitting on the tracks. And now there's like a burning train coming north from the Busan direction that just careens into everything. And
so heartbreaking, even though I haven't like studied much, didn't live at that time, but yeah.
Exactly, yeah. Nowhere was safe. Literally nowhere was safe. Like if you look at the map of like safe territory during the Korean War, it was literally just Busan for like the first few months. So finally, nowhere else is safe. The only place left to go is Busan, just like in Train to Busan. The final plot point, gotta go to Busan. So they struggle, whoever's left at this point. At this point, more than half of the Koreans who started heading south have probably been wiped out, either from hunger, or like along the way they got lost, straggled behind, or they were shot at by military. So by the time they finally get to Busan, there's a perimeter now. The US Army has arrived already in this area, they stake their claim, and South Korean Army as well. They stake their claim. Busan is safe, but it's overcrowded, so they really have to be sure of who they're letting in. Similarly, in Train to Busan, when they arrive, they have to get off the train and walk through the tunnel, and you see like these army guys like pretty much ready to shoot. They're like, who is this? Who's coming? They probably assume it's a zombie. It would have been very similar during the Korean War. You would have been highly suspicious. And I know like a lot of, I can't speak for the Korean troops, but I know a lot of American troops were very suspicious, even of civilians. They thought somehow they were hiding guns, weapons. They thought they were North Korean spies. So they would have likely been in a similar position, like, do we shoot or not? So finally, the girl sings her little peaceful song, and they realize, oh, it's just
person. I think what was even like a more sad is not just civilians being accepted or not by the military, but like embraced by the other civilians or not.
Exactly. So
when they like fought their way to meet other people in the train, those people who like were in that cart, didn't believe them. Like they like told horrible things to them, and like basically they actually kicked them out to other cart.
Yeah.
So to me that was really heartbreaking and really like a sad truth about civil war.
Because yeah.
They were all same people, they were friends, their families, like neighbors right before the war, but as soon as the war broke, now they can't trust each other.
Yeah. So I think it's just a metaphor, but like I wanted to share this because I think it would be cool if like, first of all, I want to know your thoughts. If you think I'm crazy and insane, let me know, but like kindly. This is just my opinion based on readings. But also I think if we are onto something, if it was kind of like a metaphor for the Korean War, I think it would be really cool if like Americans and other Westerners watch Train to Busan.
Oh yeah, true.
With
yeah.
that perspective, because then they can kind of understand like, okay, Train to Busan is just fiction, but like the fear that those people feel, the feeling that their whole world is burning and there's nowhere to go. They're on this one little train, that's their only safe place. That feeling, like I think it would be cool if Westerners understand that, like that's how it felt during the Korean War. Like your own neighbors, as you said, are your enemies now. You really just have you, yourself, and your family, and like the hope of reaching Busan. I think it would be cool if other people kind of know that, have that historical perspective.
I am a Korean, but to be honest, I didn't see these connections or metaphor, but she actually found it out and I was like, wow.
Yeah. I mean, it's just a theory, so we could be wrong, but I'd really love to know your opinions.
Please let us know.
Yeah. And please check out our reaction. It's on TikTok and Instagram. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.